This presentation is going to be about the cell cycle and mitosis. We don't want to enter in too much detail about the different phases, but will simply be a description of the most important events that occur during mitosis and during the cell cycle in general. Okay, the cell cycle is, we can say, is the life cycle of a cell before it reproduces, multiplies, or divides. Notice that in biology is probably the only science in which division and multiplication means the same. The typical eukaryotic cell completes the cycle in about 24 hours and is divided into big portions. Mitosis, which is the shortest and the most visible portion. When you see a histological slide, you can see you have to be lucky, but you can see the different phases of mitosis if you are lucky to see one. This is the phase in which a somatic cell divides into two daughter cells, in which the chromosome number of the parental cell is maintained. That is a very important difference with meiosis, in which we have a reduction in the number of chromosomes. Here we have two daughter cells that are identical to the parent cell. And then we have interphase. Okay, cells can live in interphase during decades. For example, neurons can live in what we call the G0, and other cells that normally don't divide can live in interphase for all of their life. Interphase is the longest part and is divided in different subphases. Interphase is the period that separates successive mitosis in cells and has mainly three phases. A G1, that is a period of cell growth. S, that stands for synthesis, is the phase in which DNA is synthesized by replicating the DNA of the cell. And also we have the replication of the centrosomes. Okay, now we have two centrosomes forming a diplosome. G2 is the second period of growth and is the period of preparation for mitosis. So let's take a look at here. This is a representation of the cell cycle. Okay, we are gonna see how or where the different parts of the cell cycle are. This shortest part is mitosis. The rest of the cycle is the interphase. And you can notice there that the interphase is subdivided in three subphases. This is the G1. This one is the S. This one is G2. So here we have the phases of cell division, cell growth, protein synthesis, and more cell growth until the new mitosis occurs. So this process takes around 24 hours, and some cells are gonna go into phase zero if they are not gonna divide anymore. For example, neurons. Well, here we have a representation with red arrows of the period of the cell cycle that belongs to the interphase of the cells. Let's take a look at the different parts. It accounts for 95% of the cell cycle. If you see a cell during interphase, you have an example here. You can see a nucleus, perfectly defined nucleus surrounded by an obvious nuclear membrane. Okay, you don't see the individual chromosomes, so they are not like in this diagram. Okay, these are how the chromosomes appear when they are condensed, when they are during mitosis, to be able, so the cells are able to separate them. Okay, so the actual representation of how the nucleus of the cell looks like in interphase is like you see in the picture. Okay, you can see an amorphous mass of chromatin that can be divided in heterochromatin or euchromatin. The euchromatin is more dense, and the heterochromatin is more dense, and the euchromatin is not as dense and is the one that is actually doing transcription, doing all the processes in the cells. So what else? Well, let's go to the G1 phase, or growth 1 phase. Okay, here is when the cell increases in size, okay, increases or produces more organelles, more mitochondria, more ribosomes. Remember, we started this phase after a mitosis. But that is something that is easy to understand using common sense. Let's say this is the parent cell. If this cell divides, it's gonna form two daughter cells that are smaller. Okay, so these cells need to grow until they reach the size of the parent cell. Okay, so increasing the number of organelles, mitochondria, ribosomes, etc., so the cells can function properly and perform their functions. Okay, then we have the S phase, or synthesis, okay, this red part here. Okay, here we have the replication of the nuclear DNA, and also the duplication of the centrosomes forming a diplosome. We are gonna see this, what this diplosome means when we see the mitosis. This duplication begins at the interface here of the G1 and S phases. So first you have the duplication of the diplosome, then you have the nuclear DNA synthesis or replication. Okay, G2 is this short phase here before mitosis actually occurs. Okay, here is when the cells start packing everything, getting everything ready for mitosis. There is a little bit of more cell growth, so the daughter cells are not so tiny. Okay, have an increased synthesis of proteins that are going to be needed later during mitosis and in the early stages of the new daughter cells. Then we have the G0. Okay, is a period, or is another state in which many cells leave. Okay, it's not part of the cycle, but it's like a stop. It's like the cells get parked there and no longer divide unless they are stimulated, because the body needs them to divide. For example, liver cells. Okay, liver cells normally don't divide, but if there is any injury, if you remove part of the liver, many of these cells are gonna divide. Okay, under certain conditions. Neurons, for example, don't divide. So they are gonna be in phase zero forever until they die. So let's go to mitosis. Okay, remember, this is the process by which cells divide to produce two identical daughter cells with the same amount of DNA, with the same number of chromosomes. Mitosis is the process in which we have chromosomal segregation. This is called karyokinesis, and cell division, cytokinesis, that occurs at the end of mitosis. And there are four stages. We have the prophase, okay, we have the metaphase, we have the anaphase, and we have the telophase before the actual cytokinesis occurs. So we can say that the first four, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase, refer to the division of the nucleus. Okay, the chromosome segregation and division. So we ensure that each daughter cell receives a nucleus that contains a proper number of chromosomes and DNA. And then we have the cytokinesis, when the cytoplasm and the cell membrane divide, and we have two new cells, two daughter cells, identical to the mother cell, to the parent cell. So let's take a look at prophase, how the cells look like in prophase. Notice that here we have the chromosomes that start to condense. Notice that the chromosomes don't appear as the cells, as the chromosomes of the cells during interphase. Okay, notice the difference of the chromosomes during interphase and the chromosomes during prophase. Okay, remember, when prophase is occurring, we already have the chromosomes or the DNA replicated. We have a double amount of DNA in each of the chromosomes. Okay, these are the chromosomes. Now we have these two sections, one is a copy of the other one, of the original one, and these are called the sister chromatids. Sister chromatids. Okay, what happens during prophase? The chromosomes are starting to condense. You notice the formation of the chromosomes. You have the duplicated centrosomes. This is one centrosome and another one forming what is called a diplosome. Okay, they start moving at opposite poles of the cells to start forming the mitotic spindle using microtubules. Okay, and in this part also the nuclear envelope disappears, and also the nucleolus. Notice that we don't see a nucleolus, starts disappearing, the nuclear envelope is starting to disintegrate. Didn't see it as clearly as during interphase, in prophase. What happens in metaphase? Okay, in metaphase we have the formation of the metaphase plate, also known as equatorial plate. Okay, the sister chromatids align, okay, at this equatorial plate. Okay, this is better seen in this diagram here. You can see the diplosomes in the ends. You can see many of these microtubules forming the spindle. It's a beautiful picture. Okay, the mitotic spindle is completed in this portion. Okay, the mitotic or spindle apparatus is composed of microtubules and these two diplosomes that are located at the two opposite ends of the cells. Okay, but chromosomes are aligned at the equatorial plate, and these are the poles where these diplosomes are located, and these lines here are the microtubules forming the spindle. So the next phase is anaphase. Anaphase is when these sister chromatids start separating. Okay, it begins abruptly, as is described here, when the chromosomes start to being drawn towards the opposite poles. Okay, these diplosomes start pulling from these microtubules, separating the sister chromatids. Okay, shortening of the spindle fibers makes them the sister chromatids to move away from the equatorial plate or metaphase plate towards the ends, toward the poles of the cells. At the end of anaphase, we are going to have aggregation of an identical set of chromosomes at each pole at the end. Okay, we are going to have aggregation of two sets of chromosomes that contain or should contain in normal conditions the same number of chromosomes. And telophase is the end. Okay, in this phase, yeah, already we have the different sets of chromosomes in the ends or in the poles of the cells. And here we have the reformation, okay, of the nuclear envelope and the nucleolus. Okay, and the chromosomal DNA starts decondensing. And we have the development of this structure here that is called the cleavage furrow, indicating where the cytoplasm is going to be divided. It's called cytokinesis, and will mark the division of the cells, final division of the cells, leading to cytokinesis. If you notice here in this slide, you can see that there is still some material that is shared by the two daughter cells, and this would be the furrow, this cleavage furrow, but these cells still have to separate completely. Okay, we still don't have a defined nucleus. We still can appreciate some of the chromosomes. At the end, the completion of mitosis is cytokinesis. Okay, the cytoplasm divides completely. We have a formation of a new cell membrane that separates the two daughter cells. Each one has a set of paired homologous chromosomes. And here you can see, well, and of course you have again the cell membrane, the nuclear membrane, you can see perfectly. The nuclear membrane is very well defined there. And a darker area will appear, that is the nucleolus. And here you have all the different phases, how the cells look like in interphase, how they look like in prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, and at the end, cytokinesis. Thank you so much for watching.